I can see, have I got buzz tops all over the most ill-conceived, hastily assembled bodge job since the Millennium Bridge, where we take all the best elements out of TV's top three quizzes and try to make a show out of what's left. That being, right hand, the actor and writer who is directly related to the famous family of chocolate makers, so please welcome Stephen Finger of Fudge. Round one, then, and the picture board will be a sensible way to start, which is why we're going to play Odd One Out. One oddness each to identify who is it and why. Nick's team, your tough nuts are Graham Souness, Francis Rossi, Edwina Curry, and Tycho Brahe.
From the picture, Tycho Brahe is the only one who was in Elizabethan Celebrity Squares.
The link between Tycho Brahe, he was 16th century, wasn't he?
Yeah.
Was like that the origin of status quo, wasn't it? There must be some sort of connection.
Tycho Brahe grew a moustache to prove his masculinity. Like Francis Rossi grew pigtail to prove his masculinity, Graham Souness grew a moustache to prove his masculinity,
yes.
And Edwina Curry doesn't need to prove her masculinity.
So is it Francis Rossi is the only one without a moustache?
Is that a nose? Is he without a nose?
Yeah. Is Graham Souness the only one who doesn't understand the offside law?
No, that's not actually the answer, although very amusing. You were close, actually, when you were in the nose.
Well, there was a story about Rossi, his nose fell out in a shower.
Mm. Oh, yes, that's right. Hasn't he got a gold septum?
He filled it with the devil
dandruff,
didn't he? Yes, because Graham Souness had a heart attack of some kind. No one talked about it because, of course, he said Souness mended. But and Edwina Curry, I fear, had a nose job too, didn't she?
What about Brahe?
Brahe. Tycho is actually only really famous for one thing.
He did have a golden something, a golden nose, a golden nose.
The man with the golden nose.
He was the man.
Fantastic film.
Perhaps they've always, is it gold, the septum of Mr. Rossi?
So they've had nose jobs. Those two have had nose jobs, and Graham Souness
would have a pacemaker, perhaps.
I'm going to give you one point, because you are...
And Graham Souness couldn't smell a shit player if he came and stood right next to him.
No, the answer is that they've all had nose jobs, apart from Francis Rossi, who the middle of whose nose simply fell out in the shower.
He had it replaced by something, so therefore he's had a nose job.
He hasn't had a nose job, no.
Edwina Curry's had a nose job.
Edwina Curry's had a nose job.
Well, to make it look better.
It's amazing, isn't it? Yes, she had it broken as a child,
I can't imagine why.
Lovely child. You actually had to have it rebroken and set.
I bet you the surgeon just made that up. We have to re-break it.
I have a bent nose.
I'm sorry to hear that, Stephen.
Yes.
No. But you haven't had a nose job?
No.
Would you ever?
No, because let's face it, it would be rather disappointing to discover when I woke up after the surgery that I was still lazy looking like a dog turd.
Do you know how Tycho came about to have a golden nose?
He was in a duel.
Duel, that's right. That's right. They were having a duel about who was the best mathematician. Francis Rossi can't have had a nose job because he has a party trick.
He doesn't do that sort of thing, does he? Flosses his oh dear.
He puts a cotton bud between his nostrils and puts it in one nostril, pulls it out the other.
Still better than learning a chord change, I suppose, isn't it?
They've all had nose jobs apart from Francis Rossi. A Liverpool player in the 1980s, Graham Souness, had his septum repositioned, a piece of cartilage removed, and his nostrils completely realigned. And to this day, Vinnie Jones insists it was a fair tackle. Tycho Brahe lost his nose in a duel and replaced it with a metal one. He was a brilliant young astronomer who met an early death, hastened by his unfortunate addiction to Brasso. Status quo's cocaine-fueled lifestyle caused severe damage to Francis Rossi's nasal membrane. Rossi recalls the day he noticed a fleshy lump lying in the bottom of the shower, which luckily turned out to be Rick Parfitt. Sean team, your giants among men are Gulliver, Rolf Harris, George Harrison, and Demi Moore.
Right, Rolf here, is he trying to tell those two people behind him that their rabbit is still alive?
It'll be fine, take it home. Was it the episode of Pet Rescue where Rolf performed proctology on two cats simultaneously by gripping their tails?
I thought Pet Rescue played for Chelsea.
The other one out is Gulliver, because Rolf has scissors there. Demi Moore blunted that with rock. George Harrison covered Demi's rock with paper. And Gulliver wins because he has a 20-foot cock.
It's not even really in the right area. Although, having said that...
Is it to do with the cinema? Obviously, you can see Demi Moore in the cinema. George Harrison did Help, and Rolf Harris is those public relations movies. And Gulliver is the person you don't want sitting in front of you at the cinema. With his 20-foot cock.
Oh, it does have a penile connection.
It's both risky things, because Gulliver peed on the burning house in Lilliput in order to put it out.
Yeah, and we'd like to answer the question.
Was I on the right lines?
You were on the right lines.
Peeing on things. I think I heard something about piss. Yeah.
Well, it is. The other three used to, well, they still do actually, drink their own piss.
Who's the other three?
Well, not Gulliver, because he's fictional.
Ah.
Well, nobody would piss on Rolf Harris if he was on fire, would they?
But no, I think Sean was pretty much in the right area, yes. I'll give you 2 points for that. The answer is that they all drink their own urine, except Gulliver.
I think it's very healthy.
Yeah, but...
it's rather scented and pleasant, apparently.
It depends what you drink,
sterile. Yeah. Well, when it's fresh from the urethra, apparently.
Have you done it?
No, I must say I haven't. Not deliberately. Not my own. No.
Do you know what the medical benefits are of drinking your own urine?
You're in a babe.
You never have to flush a toilet?
Yeah. No, it has healing properties, apparently, and a toning effect when applied to the skin.
But is it also for bee stings and wasp stings because of the ammonia?
And yet, I can't see it being a big seller, you know. Well, there's no point in selling it if it's your own, is it?
Call it something like they
call it. By Calvin Klein, would you?
Yes, so the answer is they all drink their own urine except Gulliver, who used it to put out the Queen of Lilliput Burning Palace. With ex-husband Bruce Willis, Demi Moore has three children, Rumour Glenn, Scout LaRue and Tallulah Bell, all of whom flew successful bombing missions during the Second World War. In Gulliver's travels, when the tiny palace of Lilliput was on fire, Gulliver came to the rescue with a one-man fire engine by using his penis as a hose, although the crowd's cheers turned to gasps when he converted it into an extension ladder. So, at the end of that round, it's Sean's team who've raced into an unassailable lead, ahead as they are 2-1.
Phone 08457 910 910 now.
And so, having assembled representatives from the three best-known quiz shows, we now take a game from a completely different one. To wit, What Happened Next, Sean's team, your musical flavour is... Coconut.
Can I drag you across the piano?
Right.
Put
your
bit
of it anyway, all right?
A snatch of the penis
of
Alada song.
Okay, I'll give you some mild support.
But I must say, Reuben Horn goes in. Now, I'm in a bottomless jacket here. Will you help me with this?
Oh, Tony Morgan, he writes in your dad.
Does he?
It's very shame of him.
Must have been hell at home.
He was lovely. I'd like Terry to put me on his knee, actually, and dig me up and down.
I think.
Who was that bloke?
Terry Wogan.
I knew you were going to say that. Who was the Kenny Everett look-alike?
Rupert Holmes. Rupert Holmes is the singer of Pina Colada song.
Yeah. Oh, that is George Best. Come on, go. Didn't someone mention Pina Colada?
It's not the right answer, no.
Does he shut his knob in the piano lid?
Phil says he shuts his penis in the piano lid. Let's have a look at what actually happened.